Good morning, dear students. In this class, we are going to learn about the new poem, that is Rain on the Roof. Okay, and this poem is written by Coates Gilley. Okay, so what the poet has mentioned in the poem? Okay, what is the message he is giving through the poem? Rain. He speaks here about the rain, which is very much clear from the title of the poem, Rain on the Roof. Now here, if you observe, it is written the roof. So here the poet talks particularly about the roof of his house, okay? And which suggests the childhood memories of the poet. So here the poet discusses or he is describing the memories which he gets when the rain is falling on the roof of his house. Now, as we all know, we are enjoying rain so much. So whenever it is raining, what kind of changes we observe in our mood? What is the effect of the raindrops? The sound produced by the raindrops, okay, the rain droplets on our mind, it gives us soothing and calming effect, okay, it makes our mind calm. So here also, and what is the thing that we observe, that somehow we are transformed into our different world, okay, we get ourselves into the deep thinking zone. Okay, we will find ourselves in that zone and we will be dreaming of the imaginary things, okay, which could take place or which you might want to take place. So this is the effect of the rain over our mind. It helps us to soothe our mind as well as body. It takes us to the memories of the past. Whenever it is raining, what is the thing that we would like to do? We would like to sit and relax and observe from the window outside. And sometimes we just want to get lost into our memories. So that is the effect of the rain. The same effect is experienced here by the poet also. So what is the central idea of the poem here? Healing power of the nature. The poet here discusses about the healing power of the nature through the rain. Nature has its own way of healing our problems or healing our mind and soul. Okay, so that is what discussed here. Then it also helps us to revive memories, to recollect memories, to relive the memories, which could be sweet as well as bitter memories. Memories can be of our memories can help us to feel good, but some memories may help us to feel sad as well. Okay, so it helps us to revive both the different kinds of memories, soothes and comforts and overworked mind. If you are very overstressed and you look outside the raining thing, it helps us to give a relaxation to your mind. Everybody would like to have a cup of coffee or any hot thing to on a rainy day, just to give himself or herself relaxation from the busy schedule. Okay, and it has the ability to take back to the lovely past, and it provides comfort and calmness to our mind. Now, let us read the poem and understand what kind of memories here the poet talks about his childhood. Okay, now let us begin here with the first stanza. When the humid shadow hovered over all the starry spheres, and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in the rainy tears, what a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. So now let us clear this line by line what the poet wants to say. When the humid shadow, this humid shadow is used for the clouds. Okay, now this, when some words are used to compare with some or the other things, the quality, even if they are not alike, then which kind of literary device it is used? It is used metaphor here. Okay, so here the shadows are in actually the clouds, which is mentioned by the poet. So when the shadows hover, hover here means floating in the sky, hang on in the sky over all the starry spheres. Starry sphere here refers to the stars. Okay, and what happens when they are clouds? They are over the starry sphere. They are hiding the stars. We are not able to see them. And the melancholy darkness. Melancholy here means the sadness. It is spread all over. The darkness is spread and generally leaves in the rainy tear. So here the poet gives the quality of a human. What is what quality? The trait of the human of weeping, of crying to the clouds. That is why we say the literary device personification is used in these two lines, where the poet qualifies the clouds as human beings who is gently weeping. When the rain drops are falling from the clouds, we see or we sometimes feel that the clouds are crying. Okay, so that is what the poet mentions here, and it expresses the sorrowness in his mind. So here the poet with this line expresses the sorrow which is present within himself. Okay, what a bliss to press the pillow. Now here what next the poet says? Bliss. Bliss means the happiness, the joy. In this moment of sorrow, what can revive him in the sense, can give him happiness, is only to press the pillow, to lie down on the, press your head on the pillow, to keep your head on the pillow of a cottage chamber. Chamber here means the room in his cottage, in his house, and lie listening to the patter. Lie listening to the patter means simply lying down, doing nothing, just relaxing to the patter. What is the patter? The sound which is produced by the dropping of the rain. Okay, and of the soft rain over him. So just to lie down and listen to the raindrops, the sound of the raindrops over him means above the house. Okay, above him. So that is what is mentioned here in the first stanza. He first expresses the sorrow present within himself, which is overcome, over which he is overcoming with the help of the soothing sound effect of the raindrops which is falling on his roof. Now let's read the second stanza and understand what he says here. Every tinkle on the shingles. Tinkle here means the ringing sound of the raindrops on the shingles. What are shingles? These are the wooden tiles of which the roofs are made of. Okay, so he is saying every drop which makes the tinkling sound on the roof, on the shingles, that means the tiles of the roof, has an echo in the heart. It is just like a beat in my heart. It creates a heartbeat in the there, and a thousand dreamy fancies. And with each drop, with each sound, the tinkling sound, I get a heartbeat. I could feel my heartbeat, and then I could drag myself, transform myself into a dreamy fancies. Dreamy fancies here means the imaginary stories which is going on in my mind. Okay, imaginary stories in the mind, and I am lost into my dreamy world. Into busy being stung, and I am completely taken over, busy with my dreamy things. And a thousand recollections. Recollections here refers to the memories. Okay, and what we are lost into, we are sometimes, wherever we are listening to the sound of the rain, either we are transformed into our past memories, what has already been experienced by us, or we are taken into an imaginary world by our mind, where we feel or we see things happening according to our way. Okay, Then beat their air cracks into the wood. And what he says there, in these two lines, he says, and a thousand recollections. There are thousand of memories of my past, which is coming into my mind, recollecting, and weave their air threads into a woof. And it is beautifully weaving. What is weaving? Weaving is the process to make a fabric or a cloth, we can say that. So he says there, these memories are coming in a flashback, and then it is woven into a beautiful picture, into a beautiful story. So what he says here, now, when the poet here says the pictures, the memories are woven into a beautiful pictures, into a story. So here the poet compares the weavers with the pictures, the memories. So here again in these two lines, metaphor is used, which is like weaving fabrics, making of cloth is compared to the task of making of the stories, the imaginary, memories here, which is being woven into a complete picture. Okay, so here, now, as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof, as I am listening to the patter, to the sound of the dropping of the rain, now, this is what is happening with me. I am completely lost into my childhood memories. So in the first stanza, he speaks about the what is he liking to do on the rainy day, okay, or when it is raining, what is happening with him. And then in the second stanza, he speaks about how he is lost into his childhood memories, okay, the sweet memories. Now, let us read third stanza. Now, in memory comes my mother. Now, when he is lost in childhood memories, which is the first person he remembers? He remembers his mother, as she used in years ago. Years agone means gone by, which is already passed. So he would remember those years which has already been passed when he was a small child. What his mother used to do, he is remembering that now when he is listening to the raindrop. What he remembers about his mother, let's see. To regard the darling dreamers. To regard here means to observe, to look over the darling dreamers. Here, the darling dreamers are who? The poet and his siblings. Okay, so what his mother used to do when it was he is remembering now, his mother used to come and look over, observe the children are sleeping peacefully, calmly. Okay, the poet and his siblings. And she left them till the dawn. Before she left them till the dawn. Dawn here means the morning. Third here stands for before. And she would sit there by them and observe them, look at them, staring at them very lovingly, with the eyes full of love and care. Okay, and she would observe them, keep on looking on them, and then, oh, I feel her fond look on me. Fond look on me. She was very fond on looking at the sleeping, at her sleeping children, at me, the poet, as I list to refrain, as I listen to the refrain. Refrain means what? Put the song that is repeated. What is repeated here? Throughout the poem, the poet is telling us or repeating the same thing, that is the sound effect of the rain that is having on the poet's mind. As I listen to the sound effect of the poet, what is happening with me? The memories are coming one by one. And what memories he shares with us is the memory of his mother. He is remembering, recalling his mother, how she used to lovingly watch them, see them when they were sleeping. The poet and the siblings were sleeping, and she was very fond of doing so. She loved sitting by them and then giving them a very loving look. Okay. And I am as listening to the sound, it's coming again and again, which is played upon the played upon the singles. Okay. Now the sound, the refrain. Here the refrain, as I told you, this word stands for the sound which is repeated. Okay, the same sound with each and every drop of the rain, you are going to experience the same sound which is being played upon the shingles, that is upon the tiles of the roof, the same sound. By the patter of the rain, by the patter of the rain, the dropping of the rain drop. Now, what do we observe here? See, darling dreamers. Who is referred as darling dreamers? The poet and the siblings. So here again the poet uses metaphor. Okay, metaphor, because darling dreamers stand for the children here. Okay, now what else we see here? Towards the end of the poem, he is lost into the memory of his mother. Okay, how he remembers, how he connects, how the poet says here that what is the effect of the rain on his mind. He is lost into his childhood memories, and he is now, the rain is giving him comfort in the present moment also. How? By giving, recollecting the memories. Okay, his mother is not there with him now, but he feels little, you can say little happy, or there is a kind of joy in his heart when he recalls all the memories of his mother and his siblings. Okay, so now let's see what are the other literary devices, as I told you about personification and the metaphor. Next is refrain. What is refrain? Phrase or verb phrase repeated at intervals. If you observe from the poem, the word here, pattern of the rain is repeated every time. So here the literary device refrain is used in the poem. Now what is the next one? Alliteration. Alliteration, you already know, repetition of the consonant sound in the same line. Now that is the verb for you. Now observe here, memory, mother, okay, both are having the M repeated sound in the same line. So how many alliterations are there throughout the poem? It is your work to find out and tell me that. The last literary device which we have to discuss is onomatopoeia. Now what is this device? In this, what is happening? The words which are used to express the sound effect, those are used in this literary device. Like here, if you observe this word patter is used again, then tinkle is used to express the sound effect. What are the words that is not used in the poem, like bang or hiss? So these are the words which are used to express the sound effect. Now what is the message that we get from this poem, Rain on the Roof, by the poet? Here he expresses that Mother Nature has its own way to heal the minds of human beings as well as the earth. Here the rain, which gives a soothing effect to the mind of the poet, he expresses here that it is able to heal the sorrow present in his heart, and he remembers and recalls the memories of his mother and her love. So it gives a soothing effect to his mind. In the same way, the Mother Nature, through rain and through the other different ways, it has many different properties of the nature which gives us a soothing effect to our mind, heals our mind, body and soul, heals also the surroundings around us. Okay, so this is what is mentioned in the poem. I hope all this is clear to you. I will be sending you this PDF in which the meanings of all the difficult words are written, as well as the literary devices which is used here in the poem, that is also mentioned here. So you can go through it, read it carefully line by line, understand and listen to me to the audio also. If any difficulty, you can ask me. Have a good day.